Talk briefly about the Enough Project in general, your focus on Africa, and what you've achieved so far.
Yep. We started 4 years ago, I think now, and the idea was basically to have an organization which focuses on genocide and mass atrocities, the prevention thereof, and has people out in the field doing analysis in these countries that are being impacted by it, doing the analysis in the field, having people in Washington who can then take that good field analysis, present it to Congress, present it to the administration, and then also go out into the American public and educate the public about what is happening and what's going on there. So it's a soup to nuts. It's from the grassroots in the U.S., people who care about this stuff, all the way to the areas impacted by war in the zones of conflict that we're working on. We started with three conflicts. We didn't want to be Human Rights Watch or Amnesty working on every conflict or every crisis in the world. We just wanted to work on a few and try to make some headway in those. We work on the LRA, the Lord's Resistance Army crisis, trying to bring an end to the LRA. We work on Congo, which is the deadliest war in the world, and we work on the Sudan, South Sudan conundrum. And so those are our three big ones. We've done a lot of work on Somalia too, but the three core issues, and we try to build constituencies. Again, religious institutions and students are usually the core of these human rights movements, but there are lots of other communities that care about it, women's groups and all kinds of, and we focus on our outreach to get Americans more educated and energized about places halfway around the world that we actually, with some positive involvement, can help make a big difference in people's lives.
And you use an approach called the three P's: peace, protection, and punishment. Briefly, talk about how you do that.
Yeah, you know, because they're often, one of the things that I got frustrated with working for other organizations was that they often had one specific thing that they would focus on, that the answer to the problems that they were addressing was through one lens, you know? And I think it's much more complicated than that. So even three is difficult because the world is just, you know, is a complex place. But by focusing on those three, the peace effort allows for the negotiations and diplomacy writ large, not just peace processes, but the leverage behind peace process, protection. You know, in many of these situations, people are being attacked on the basis of their ethnicity or their religion or their race or their geography, and they need protection. That's why we send peacekeeping forces, but often those peacekeeping forces are not effectively deployed, and there are ways to make them more effective in protecting civilian populations. So it's that kind of stuff, and then punishment is really about accountability. It's about justice. You know, is that when there are terrible crimes against humanity that have been committed, there needs to be some kind of answering for those crimes. So we've been very strong supporters of the International Criminal Court, but we're also very strong supporters of building up the indigenous judicial capacities of the states that we work on.